We all know what happened in 2017 with the Houston Astros. Even non-baseball fans are well aware. So if you don't know at this point, you're not even living in a box. You're probably just dead. Okay, that got dark pretty quick. Let's bring it back to the light. Everyone knows about the Houston Trastros jokes. Bang bang, trash can, Houston cheated in 2017. Okay, that's been dealt with. Well, sort of. The Astros players probably should have gotten more of a punishment than they did, but oh well, whatever. It's over now. During the investigation back at the beginning of 2020, there was a question raised at one point. It was confirmed that the Astros cheated in 2017 and for some of 2018, using the replay room and cameraman to decode signs from the dugout to home plate to alert the batter what pitch was coming. Us fans, being the crazy beings that we are, decided to take matters into our own hands and look at past Astros games to look if any suspicious activities were going on, almost like being a part of the investigation ourselves. Of course, all the trash can bang games came into play, but what fans also speculated on was that the Houston Astros were using buzzers, or in other words, a device that buzzes in a certain way when a certain pitch is coming. The Astros denied this and still have to this day, but this all begs the question, did they use buzzers, why would they use buzzers, and was this the first time it's allegedly happened before in baseball? Take a second to like this video, and if you're new to the channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button for future baseball content. In Game 6 of the 2019 American League Championship Series, Jose Altuve hit one of the most iconic home runs in Astros history, a walk-off against the Aroldis Chapman and the Yankees to send Houston to the World Series. Everything seemed to be normal. That is until Altuve rounded third to go touch home plate where a mob of his Houston Astros teammates were there waiting for him. Usually when you hit a home run that big, you don't care what happens to you. You black out, running around the bases, so if your jersey gets ripped off, you couldn't care less. Heck, if you're half naked by the end of the celebration, you don't care about that either. We've seen this time and time again with players hitting walk-offs, whether in the regular season or postseason, with Altuve being one of those guys who has gotten his shirt ripped off before. What Altuve did was incredibly strange. As he was running toward home plate, he yelled to his teammates not to rip off his jersey, and after celebrating for a few seconds, rushed to the clubhouse as fast as he could to change his shirt. Makes you think. The theory is that Jose Altuve was wearing a buzzer while hitting that infamous home run, and did everything he could to hide that fact. Ken Rosenthal even took initiative to ask Altuve about his actions himself while doing the post-game interview, and this is what Altuve had to say.
You asked the teammates not to tear your shirt. Why?
What's that?
Did you ask your teammates not to tear your shirt? Why was that?
I don't know. I'm too shy. Last time they did that, I got in trouble with my wife.
Anyone else think about how he asked to hear that question again? He probably realized that Ken noticed what he did and almost crapped himself. And as for the answer he gave, it's hard to buy that. I mean, your wife didn't want you to take your shirt off, seriously?
Take your shirt off!
Take your shirt off!
There was also another video that surfaced the interwebs that made people question the buzzers, with this taking place during the World Series that same very year. In the middle of an at-bat, catcher Robinson Chirinos swung and missed at what looked like a changeup from Patrick Corbin. Right as he completes the swing, something seems to fly off the end of the bat. Chirinos then proceeded to walk in front of home plate to grab whatever it was that fell into the dirt, later telling the umpire that it was just some sort of sticker from the bat. Again, makes you think. If you were wondering if this was the only alleged case of baseball players using buzzers to help them know what pitch is coming, well, it is not. Believe it or not, the first recorded instance of players supposedly using buzzers goes all the way back to 1900, where Morgan Murphy, who was a backup catcher, was used to steal signs with Phillies coach Pierce Chiles. What he did was stand on a box with electric wires that relayed to him coded messages in the form of electrical buzzes about what pitch was coming, which he then communicated to the batters by stomping on the ground. He would get one buzz for a fastball, two for a curveball, and three for a changeup. No action was taken against this by Major League Baseball, though. I'm not sure the Astros ever used buzzers, but if it was ever confirmed that they did, it would make a lot of sense. The Altuve incident along with the Chirinos one, and just the sheer fact that they were proven to cheat in 2017. So why wouldn't they continue to do it again if it worked the way it did? What the Astros did in 2017 was pretty subtle, the way they cheated, but the buzzer thing is even more subtle. After what the Astros were able to do in 2017 with the sign stealing, I would not be shocked to find out that they had a meeting and decided on a way to cheat even better, like a more advanced way of doing it, which would have of course been the buzzers. The Houston Astros might have used buzzers in 2019, or they might have not. Either way, it's still a meme and forever will be. A funny one, at that. The Astros obviously aren't cheating anymore, certainly aren't using any kind of buzzer, but are also definitely not getting any love on the road, which I guess is part of their punishment. We may never actually know if they ever used buzzers during the 2019 season and postseason, but at this point, it really doesn't matter. It's just a fun conspiracy to think about. Let me know in the comments what you believe to be true. And for those wondering about the Astros Twitter account, this tweet certainly did not age that well.